Hello everyone, welcome back to Existence. My name is McPeach Pies, and today we're going to be getting started on our latest project, which is the Community Item Storage System thing, which I still haven't properly figured out a name for. But first, there's a fish. Madcat has let me know that apparently my house is quite smelly, and I don't know how he's managed to have a fish there that hasn't despawned. Unless he's been on recently, but I don't know if he has. I think that's all he's done. I've been looking around. I don't know if that's flipped upside down. Been looking around. I checked all my chests to see. Maybe was he in the furnace? No. I don't know. He said my house was smelly, and I assumed it was in some type of. Is it nighttime? I never noticed. Some type of rebuttal to me filling all his chests with fish. But I don't know. So, anyway, we're going to be working on the item sorter today. But first, I need to go kill MC a couple of times. I think I just figured out what MC's doing. His head is a cake. Yep. Sneak attack. I don't think it's gonna work. It dropped his normal head for me. I better tell him that it looks normal. Hang on a second, it's a cake now. So are you trying to get cakes for everyone?
Well, I was gonna get cakes for all the new members.
Oh yeah. Do you know what Madcat's done to my house? Because yeah. I found a fish. You do know
I
what he's done.
I did.
Oh, God.
I spent quite a while yesterday looking for it.
For what he's done?
Yes.
I don't know what he's done. It's just all I found was that fish.
Yeah. Yes.
You're not going to tell me, are you?
No.
Great.
You have to have a stinky house for a while.
Well, while you're here, do you want to... I noticed somebody put these torches here in front of the police department. The doors are broken. They can stay broken. Do you want to change some skins for me? I want to get some little bookshelves and stuff.
Yes.
I'll pay you for them. Isn't that how it works?
Yes.
Great. I'll go find some skins and I'll let you know. I found another fish.
Oh, yeah, there's two.
Two? Are they dispensers or something? Droppers?
Maybe. Oh, you won't be able to find them.
Where are they? Are they under here? Oh, hang on, where's my axe? Silk touch.
Yeah, I looked under there a lot.
Why is this full of dirt? And... the heck?
That was probably me pillaring up.
No, but why is this whole bit here full of dirt and blocks? Where my beacon was.
Oh, is that where your beacon was? I was wondering why this was mined out.
How far down are they? Are they like right at the bottom of the world? They are, aren't they?
Yep.
God damn it, I'm gonna go find them later. I'll find them when I'm like strip mining or something. Oh well. Thanks, Madcat. Ow.
I was pulled back
then. Illegal pills and a bone. An illegal spout wrong. Alright guys, a quick change of plan. We're not going to be working on our new project today. We're actually going to be giving a new member a little tour. So let's jump in Discord and go say hi. Alright, well, welcome to Existence, Sam.
Thank you.
So you were on an SMP, but it got shut down, didn't it?
Right, yeah. So here I am now.
Here you are now. Hopefully we will still be going strong for a little bit longer. That was one of the main reasons of doing more or less a new members phase was, you know, to get some life back in the server. Because we were getting
exactly.
A bit of inactivity. People have been quite busy recently and we've had quite a few members leaving and all that stuff. So we decided to go out and search for some new members and you were the first one to be part of that phase. So welcome.
Yes.
If you look over here, you can see the beacon. That's where Callan's base is. Callan's my brother.
Awesome.
So he gets a little bit of priority in terms of not being kicked.
Gotcha.
But, you know, I'm working with him on getting his videos. And I know that he's in the middle of making a video. It's just he likes to play Battlefield more. also to the in that direction is Mad Cat's and Ruben or Sugar Candy's base. We can go have a look at those later. The only way to get to Ruben's is by railroad. His Reedy Railroads, you might have heard of them. They're kind of going everywhere and he's still working on them. It's a big project that's probably never going to end because we're always going to be making new railways. But the main path into town, I guess you can say, used to be this one here. We'll kind of cut that off and diverted it through the farming area here. So this is just a big, it's more or less just a big open area that's all lit up. Was initially intended by Pineapple for big farms. This is the farm, Pineapple's farm, that tall building there that has been literally been progressively built over probably the lifetime of the server.
Oh, wow. It's so is this just like all villager made?
No. It's completely manual. Well,
I mean, so you can't kind of build your heart with
it. Nobody's ever used it, I don't think. I think it just sits here, and I don't know if it's actually functional or not. You can get to it down here somewhere. But Pineapple has started so many projects that he hasn't finished a single one. I don't think he has anyway. I'm trying to think what he's actually... Oh, the slime farm. Slime farm's finished. He actually did that one.
Right, yeah.
The nether portal there. But yeah, he's got so many projects going, and he's starting to now finish them up. So hopefully that farm will be done soon, because it's been there for a long time. So we have been through quite a lot of changes over the lifetime of the server in terms of members and stuff. Some, you know, have just kind of abandoned us. Some have decided, you know, it's best for them to leave, and others we just don't hear from, so it is a bit rough, you know. But we've still got, you know, we've still got people going, and now we're pretty happy to have some new people that were looking good. I don't know if
like
you can,
me.
Yeah, like you throw your stake up. I wish you could drop items from your offhand, but you actually have to move them to your main hand. If you ever need cooked fish, I sell them. I sell cooked fish.
How much?
I can't remember the price actually, but. I probably will make it free in 1.11 because they've made it when guardians die by lava or fire, they drop cooked fish.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so I don't know if you've seen my... You've probably seen my guardian farm. It's quite efficient. I get quite a lot of drops from it, so I think that's going to be a good thing, and I think I'm just going to have to give it all away because I have enough fish.
I'll take all of it.
Yeah. If you can see up on that hill there, just off that way.
Oh, yeah, is that Mad Cat's or...?
No, that is Nora's house. That is my pet polar bear. TC polar bear to me, and that's where she lives now, up on that hill. But yeah, over here is... Let's see. Lost members. So Cyril was very active, and he was awesome, but unfortunately he decided just to leave YouTube together just so he could, you know, get on with other things. Artifu, last I heard from him... not entirely sure. I think he said that he just got busy with school or something, and then he kind of never replied. So we don't know what's happening. Aussie Fox, yeah, he's kind of basically bred chickens and left. He had a chicken shop and a chicken farm, and that was kind of it. And then Mr. Blocks. Made one vid, then left. He kind of made two, but more or less one. But yeah, so we'll probably be adding to this because I know that now who else is left? I can't remember. I'll have to go back and check the list. But anyway.
So a lot of people.
A couple. I mean, it feels like a lot, but really it's not too many. But yeah, you know, when one person leaves, like, without... you know, intending to, when, you know, they just disappear, that's kind of when it's a little bit annoying. Like, Cyril, he left for himself and, you know, for getting on with other things, so that's all good. But, you know, when other people, when they just kind of leave without really saying anything, that's when it sucks. And what is the zombie going to do? It's going to come down there. Oh, damn it.
I'll just make sure I don't add to that list.
Oh my gosh, so many mobs.
This is crazy.
Oh, now we're getting swarmed. Okay, we need to sleep.
And there's one chilling out in the water over there.
Yeah, they kind of get around. this is the port, or during Ruben's, or the dock. Now, when Ruben came through here on April 1st and pretty much renamed everything to be like a fashion and like a shopping center, this turned into Paris.
Oh my god.
You will still find signs. Like, one of my favorite ones is coming down to the zombie spawner. It says, warning, hysterical girls, and it's like, JK, we don't have any girls.
That's awesome.
Yeah, there's still signs
everywhere. Now I need to invite a new girl.
Yeah. But yeah, there used to be a jungle tree about here that I keep growing and Ruben keep cutting down, and I'm tempted to grow it again just to annoy him, but I think it's best just to leave it for now. Oh my god, mom, die. There we go. Yeah, that's Lord Crazy's witchery or house, that big glass thing on the edge of the hill there, to over the lake there. As you can see, it's got holes in the windows from where I think Pineapple threw rocks into them. But that was a while ago now.
He broke his flying rock, right?
Yeah. And to the right of that is Aussie Fox's house up on that hill. He built that basically straight away, and that's kind of how it's been since. And then on the cliff face behind that, you can probably see Cyril's modern-looking house up on the hill there. It's a pretty cool hill, and it's a pretty cool house. Got some good real estate right there. Over here is the town hall that Dragon has been working on. It's a work in progress, and now he's gone on a bit of a break just while he gets some stuff done at school. But I believe him and TC are going to be working through it and getting it done soon. What else have we got here? The post
the
office.
Mail house.
Yeah, you'll become quite familiar with this very quickly. It's a main point of transferring items. It's usually used for things like filling people's things with random cryptic messages.
Pineapple.
Yeah, pretty much. I think everyone... Oh, that's another new member who we'll have soon.
What?
And then... Yeah, this usually happens, and it makes me feel really sad because I never get given things like this. Basically, when Cyril, Madcat, and Diamondback joined, TC went and gave them all like a stack of diamonds because he can do that because he's pretty rich.
Wow.
And I think MC's done that for you and Kabood over here. Hopefully,
should I read this out loud?
Kabood soon. If you want, yes. Ooh, is that a secret entrance now? It is. It wasn't a secret entrance before. I think it's just an access tunnel.
That's awesome. 64 diamonds.
Yeah, that's basically like a very good starter kit compared to the amount of diamonds I actually have. So be grateful for that because he doesn't give me diamonds.
You just received a giant portrait and a bunch of diamonds also, though, right?
Yeah, true. That is true. I guess that kind of...
Just not 64.
Just not 64, yeah. So I guess that kind of balances out. But yeah, so this is the post office. It used to be just this back wall here. This kind of extension here was made by TC when we got too many members. But no, now what? It's good because it means that we can kind of expand it along. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and do you have a banner design or anything you use as a banner?
I do. I'm thinking about switching it. I think there'd be like a cool way to make a goldfish, but...
Oh, yeah. Well, when you do, you can
have
it up
one
up the top here above wherever. Oh, that's right.
Oh, no, not my head, not my head, not my head. I want zero deaths. No.
It's traditional. You'll get used to it. Now, where's your head? Oh, I just killed you for nothing. I haven't actually set up the command blocks.
No.
Oh, well, thanks for the diamonds.
Boy.
I'll report myself to the police department.
You can arrest me for dying.
Well, that was stupid. I should really go set up the command block, shouldn't I?
Robbing.
Oh my gosh. Quick, let's go put it in the mail, in the post office. Oh gosh. I should probably set up the other command blocks too before I forget, but I'll do that later. Where was your one? Here. Do you like how I put Samuel on your name tag there?
Oh my god. That wasn't... Okay. After I said, okay, don't call me Samuel, I knew somebody was going to go ahead and...
Yep. Here we have TC's pineapple. That's not pineapple's pineapple, it's TC's pineapple.
Oh, that confuses me.
Pretty much every time we get or every new member we've ever had thinks this is pineapple's base. The dog. Oh, the cat. Can you feed... You can't feed cats cooked fish.
I mean, I'm sure this is done deliberately, but like...
I can't remember why he made it. I'm not entirely sure, actually. He just made it, and I'm pretty sure they're all... Are they all jack-o'-lanterns?
Yeah, because it probably keeps it lit up.
I think... Yeah, they are lit pumpkins. So yeah, this thing glows at nighttime. It's pretty awesome. But yeah, he kind of built that quite quickly as well. A lot of stuff happened around here within the first few weeks, and it's pretty awesome. And I mean, it's still changing from time to time with my house and stuff. But yeah, so it's really anywhere is basically open. You can take over, I guess, any of the old members' bases if you really wanted. Cyril's got quite a good place on that hill there. but yeah, really, there's just, I mean, it's an open world, and you don't have to live near spawn, but like you said, you know, it is where the action happens. Yeah. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Ooh. Okay, I'm going.
Oh, you know what? I have ender pearls.
Oh yeah,
just screw life. Ooh. I'm going. Where'd you go? Are you down below me?
I'm back down at kind of the port area or the docks area.
Okay.
And I'm on fire. Oh, there you are.
I'm at the sign where it says dock. Yeah, there we go.
But yeah, really anywhere around here is pretty open. Some of the more open areas, I guess this way, in the towards around spawn is a bit more open. There are just mobs everywhere. Holy moly.
Should we sleep again?
Uh oh. Save Perry. How did he?
Oh no. No.
He better not be dead. We can't lose Perry. No.
No. Please. Go.
He's alive. Quick.
Oh my god.
Defend the base.
I'll go sleep. You defend the base.
How the heck do one? I bet one spawned on the roof. I'm pretty sure that's spawnable area up there. Oh my gosh.
You just have to let him survive for another 10 minutes or
so. There are so many zombies right now. Like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Holy moly.
Okay.
I need to go on that roof somehow.
You want to explain to people who Piri, or I don't know how to pronounce his name, who he is?
He was the owner of the juice bar that Mr. Block made. Yeah, look, they can spawn up here, like, easy peasy. Yeah, he was just the owner, and then somebody put my... originally it was the juice bar, and then TC delivered a villager here to run the juice bar. And then somebody put my head on the villager.
So, the no sixers and everything.
Yep. I don't know who named it or managed to name it like that, because you had to use different tricks or something to name villages, didn't you? If I remember correctly.
Yeah, there's a way to do it now.
Yeah, now 1.11 you can just right click on them as normal. My gosh. So many mobs. There's like more zombies than the zombie farm producers. There you go, that should be the end of it. I'm just going to throw a couple more torches down too, because I don't actually know what is spawnable here.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you can put carpet on the roof or something.
Oh yeah, could do. I just threw some torches up there for now.
Right.
And where's the gate? Alright, Perry's saved.
Called enderpearling.
yeah. What else could we go have a look at? I mean, that's basically the gist of spawn, and the nether hub kind of leads basically everywhere. I mean, that's still a work in progress too. I've done the whole kind of bottom level of it, but mm-hmm. the whole there's an upstairs part or elevator that TC built that all really needs laying out, and eventually I'm going to build like, or someone's going to build big ice paths to like the mesa and ice spikes and stuff. We have 2 ocean temples, 2 guardian farms. My one produces far too many drops, and TC's produces probably just enough, but with
ink sacks.
Yeah, so that's pretty awesome if you ever need ink sacks. Well, I think TC's got a shop now that sells them. He made like a dye and flower shop, and I think it sells ink sacks there too, so always a place to get those. But yeah, speaking of shops, we might as well head over there. The economy.
Was that a pun? Because I know there's a head shop.
There is a head shop, that's right. It never really got used until, I was going to get some stuff like a goldfish bowl, some bookshelves and stuff. You know how you can get little player heads and stuff.
Right.
Me and MC were playing around with it yesterday, and we could not get a skin to stay on the head. It kept changing to the one that he changed his skin to. So we're not sure if that whole system is kind of gone now, if you can actually do it at all anymore, but... Yeah, there is a head shop, and I'm pretty sure you can pay MC to kill people to get their heads for you. Otherwise, I know that he has... It's like a hitman kind of thing. Otherwise, I know,
the
yeah.
Shopping,
yeah, this is the... Well, the shopping circle? I don't know what TC called it. Me and Ruben made this a while back. And it's kind of, it has evolved quite well. I've got a couple of shops here. The economy's not really too big, mainly because I guess it's just because we're a bit of a smaller server. It's nothing like Hermitcraft, where it's just
right.
a massive amount of shops. I mean, there's of course, you know, there's things like the Guardian Farms and Ruben's House and all that that we could go over look at, but I think the main thing for this that we need to do for a tour is kind of just getting the gist of the server and around the spawn and stuff.
Right.
Kind of a brief history, which I've given you. Both the ups and downs of the server and the history and how things have changed and all that stuff. But, yeah, I think... Did you see that zombie?
What happened?
It basically just jumped off the side of that cliff to track us.
Here, I'm gonna go kill him.
Wow, nice shot. You missed it, because it's dead.
Aw. Whoops.
Hang on, I'll swim over to you. No, 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 no. I love doing this. And do that.
Do you watch yourself in F5?
Yeah, but it looks really derpy because you're kind of just looking straight down into the water or straight up from the water.
Oh, that's hilarious.
And you just go, meow. Whoa, massive jump there.
Whoa.
Don't know what just happened, but you can do weird things for the light choice, swear.
I know.
But yeah, so the server's getting along. We're getting there, still going through it. You know, uploads, I think you kind of know the gist of uploads, kind of once a week or every second week or so. Once a week is kind of, it was the initial kind of standard for uploading, and I think I pretty much, I know that I do, TC kind of sticks to it from time to time, but we loosened up it a bit to kind of every second week, just so people didn't have to, you know, get too much pressure from school and stuff to upload and make videos.
Right.
But I think you'll be more than capable of anything anyway, because I've seen, you know, your stuff and you keep regularly doing it and all that good stuff.
I try.
Yeah, so I think, you know, that's what we're really looking out for with new members at the moment, is people, you know, who can...
you lost me.
You jumped out. You know, people who by can, accident. You know, keep up with, you know, who are committed to their channel, really, because I think that's some of what's happened in the past, is people, you know, just haven't been committed enough to their channel and kind of, you know, given up on, basically, their channel and therefore given up on existence here. So...
Right.
You know, we're all pretty happy. It was more or less just a unanimous decision to let you join in. So we're all pretty excited to have you part of the server.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
All good. And I will probably leave you here, and I need to go finish a Game Over 4 episode. Because when I'm not working, I'm playing Minecraft. Holy creeper.
Oh, run, run, run.
It didn't even see me. Why can't it see me? Okay, it can see me. Yeah, we're getting swarmed again, so I'm going to just basically... Oh, you're not a mob. I was about to shoot you. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the tour, and I hope Sam's viewers are all going to come subscribe to my channel. Is that how it
and
works?
And same for yours.
Yep. So everyone, go check out Sam, and I'm not sure if Kabood or... I haven't really spoken much about Kabood. We're going to have this video up around Tuesday. That's when I usually upload anyway, but that's when we're kind of going to do the whole here are our new members thing. So hopefully, Sam, your video will be up around then as well.
Awesome, yeah.
Get in contact with some of the new members and figure out, you know, if we're getting anyone else as well. But for now, I'll have everyone in the description below, including Sam, who is a new member, and definitely go check them out. And as for Sam's viewers, I'll let Sam tell you what to do, which is pretty straightforward. Just subscribe to my channel and all the other Existence members channels. And
exactly.
Oh, yeah, the Existence Discord. That's kind of where we let everyone know what's going on. The public one. There's two ones. There's a private one for the members, and then a public one where all the viewers can kind of come hang out and ask us questions and all that good stuff. There's also cheerleader tryouts there at the moment for people who want to join. but yeah, so I will leave you here, Sam, and I hope you enjoy the tour.
Thank you so much. All right, I'll see you around.
Cool. See you, Sam.